Welcome to GRR Rapidin, a fast nonsense review. Today we have Last Day of June, developed by Oversonico, an Italian gaming company that the only other game they've done so far is 2014's PS Vita game Murasaki Baby, which I have not played yet. But just by seeing some of the videos of it, you can really tell that these guys are not afraid of being different. Just look at this art direction. I find it at times to be very beautiful. The paint-like quality of the art, the blur effects that give a touch of surrealism, though I gotta say that the characters not having mouths or eyes can be a little bit unsettling. The beautiful, if not understated, soundtrack gives me the vibes of games like Flower and Journey. It plays like a very, very basic adventure game. Without an inventory system, the gameplay is limited to move, run, and interact. Also, I found that the checkpoints where it saves can be very long, and there's no real indication that it's saving, so be careful when you exit the game, you might need to do long stretches of game back again. Though the game is short in its defense. Of course, gameplay is not what this game is aiming for, it's what it's trying to convey. The idea is that you have a car accident with your wife and you get paralyzed and she dies, but now you are given the chance to understand what happened and try to stop it. This by changing the outcome of various events. You will jump from the perspective of several people back and forth trying to prevent what happened and save your wife. The game is a tale of loss, not only of the main character but also the cast, and you can really understand that from the memories you recover from the game. You can see that all of them has lost something and how they coped with it, and everything is told by gibberish. And also subtle hints, which I think can be very effective. Seeing the events unfold and how no matter what you do, you cannot prevent what's already happened, shows the five stages of grief, with denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and finally acceptance. Anyone who's lost anyone really close to them can relate. I lost my father a couple of years ago to cancer, and I can really see and feel what the game is trying to say to me. How you need to go through these stages to be able to accept the undeniable. The idea that one day you will lose someone you care so much for, and that also, one day you will leave people behind that care so much about you, and that no matter what you do, that is the only certainty in this world. In this life, which can be very ironic, time is the most valuable asset you will ever have. All the materials you might accumulate in the end is all for none. So enjoy your time here, and if you feel that this game can be up your alley, go for it. And so, thanks for watching Gokados Retro Reviews, and hasta la próxima!